I want to show you what I'm making. So, in no particular order, I'm just going to do a show and tell and put these on. I don't have specific names for these garments yet, but this one reminds me of gardening. I took a sequin applique and I made a yarn ball with handspun yarn, and it looked like a rose, and it's got knitting needles coming out of it, and it has, put it on for you, they're free size. I wanted them to fit as many people as possible. Here we go. And the base of the wrap is repurposed, basically brand new kind of blanket. I call them couch couture outfits because it's something that, like, you can wear it to bed or just on the couch having your cup of tea in the morning and be all cozy and wrapped up like a blanket. Or you can wear them to a local sheep wool festival and look extra fabulous. And this one also has sequin applique flowers on, kind of in the front. So this is one that's like a gardener wrap, yarn gardener. This one, I still have stuff that I want to add to it. I'll show you. My cats are making noise and messes in here. But this is what I call my bellwether necklace. I'm planning on silencing it because it's way too loud and obnoxious to wear, especially to a sheep and wool festival. But, like, isn't this fun? So I'm planning on having a couple of those for sale. Here is a knitting bag that I've made. And these knitting needles are the ones that I used decades ago when I was first getting back into knitting. They're from the 70s and they kept breaking. So I thought they needed to be in a yarn. And this is all freeform crochet, some hand spun, and the yarn kind of goes into the bag. And I just thought it would be fun for, like, a festival shopping bag. As I'm making these pieces, I'm keeping in mind trying to make them as free size as possible. This one would be on a smaller free size. Oh. And the yarn goes on top of the sleeve. Like this. That's how it's supposed to be worn. With all kind of drizzly drapey. Isn't that pretty? I like that one. That one's a vest. Here's another one. This one is like a kimono. And it's got a bird, like an eagle, on the back with a freeform crochet panel and a lot of sequin and sparkle. The scarf that's on this one is a loop. There we go. This one is just like rock star. Oh, so yeah, this one's really fun. This one needs to be worn with leather pants, in my opinion. So that one's one of the first ones I made, and it's long, like a long kimono. This, I think, is the second one I made. This one has sleeves that are made from recycled sari silk and handspun yarn. And it's got like a crochet panel on the back. I love the sleeves of this one. How fun is this? Rockstar. And one thing I love about the scarves is you can style them in a lot of different neat ways. You could go for like, part of my aesthetic, I've also been watching The Chosen. And so there's a little bit of like, if I was in a Bible movie aesthetic, but also you can tie these scarves, and these are all repurposed, very, very high quality textiles. So you could wear it like this, or you can wear it down. They're all hand stitched as well. All the sewing is hand done. I do not use a sewing machine. I can't stand sewing machines. But yeah, that one is really pretty. This one, here's some of the hand sewing that you can see, and that's all linen. This scarf is a handmade felted scarf that I got at an estate sale. So when I find things that are already handmade, I like to incorporate them to add to the texture and the fun. Yeah, I love the orangey red kind of matches this stripe right here, which I thought was really fun. It's more of a simple one. And I have like 10 more on my rack over here, plus these ones, plus an entire closet of about maybe 40. I love this. How fun is this? Come on, you guys. Oh, and each one has a heart on the sleeve because I wear my heart on my sleeve. I wear my heart on my sleeve, man. See, it's fun. You can just kind of tie it. Or you can be like me and be all like, you know, Mary Magdalene chic. But I can't keep them. I will show you one that I am keeping. I am keeping this one. I am keeping this one. I love this one. I love the fabric of this. Look at this. Is that not gorgeous? Ugh. Yeah, this one's mine. This one I'm keeping. And I'm going to be adding like a faux fur to it, so it's like wintry and a little bit Narnia. So this one's mine. Okay. Oh. This one, I took a sequin applique and I made a three-dimensional yarn ball with knitting needles in it. It's great for people who don't like to get hugged at festivals because it might poke people. But I thought it was cool. It looks like a yarn apocalypse. And these are, most of these wraps are free size. Like, they will fit many. Isn't that fun? I love this one. This is my cat, Euphrates. Euphrates, say hi. She's my quality control. I love the colors in this one. Oh, and each one I have my tag on the inside. It says Neauveau wearable art garment. This one has a cool applique with like rainbow sequins. More simple. And a heart on the sleeve. I love this. Like you could just, how cozy is this? You know, part of this collection is actually inspired by like pandemic wear, because it's like, if we're all gonna be home working and the cost of heat's going up, and I'm in New England, so it gets cold, I want something that I can wear and feel fabulous from couch to festival. And that's what this is. It's like wearing a blanket, like the most fabulous, fabulous blanket. Each one of these, I'm like, wait till you see this one. This one I used macrame cord as part of the fringe. I love the colors in this one. And they're so heavy. They feel, well, not all of them are heavy. Many of these are heavy, like a weighted blanket. So it's like wearing a hug. How cute is this? Isn't that sweet? Ooh, chic. Can you imagine? Like, how cool is this? I love it. I'm really enjoying making these. Each one of them feels like a piece of my heart. I mean, come on. Is that not fun? This one has a hood, which is almost as cool as pockets. This one's like a fantasy character. It's like Little Red Riding Hood goes to the Fiber Art Festival. I love it. This is all recycled. Like, this is from a designer, like expensive designer skirt that I got at an estate sale. Many of these are repurposed. This sweater is repurposed. Recycled fabrics. This is all hand woven from yarns that I've treasured. This is a yarn from a spinner in Japan. This is Esther Rogers from Jazz Turtle Creations locks. This is storybook fibers like this. Mwah. Here's another. This is a sweater I designed called Emma Jean. I'm lost. I found it. So many layers. Oh, this one is warm. This one is Emma Jean. Isn't she pretty? she's like, this is all freeform. A lot of these yarns are from the tutorials on my YouTube channel. I love it. I think it came out lovely. My pile is growing. Okay, I have three more on here and then all the rest. I'm assuming you want to see them all. This is like a vest. Isn't that fun? And this one doesn't have sleeves, so I put a little heart over here. I love how they move. And they're so forgiving in the sizing, the stretch, and the armholes. This would look pretty on a lot of people. As I've been contemplating my collection, one of my goals was to repurpose fashion. This one is more of a smaller size because it has sleeves, but I'll put it on like this so that you can see. It's very delicate. I've got a bunch of sleeves on right now, so it would be weird to put this on over it, but isn't that beautiful? It's almost bridal. My hope, though, for this collection was to repurpose textiles to keep them out of the landfill and to create as many pieces as possible that could be worn by as many people as possible, like free size, so that as your body changes, you can still wear it. Here's another one. And this one has sleeves as well. I'm just throwing it on over my shoulders so you can see. I love the textures in this one. It's cotton. I love the bit of sparkle sequin yarn in that. And here's the last one I have on the rack. A lot of fringe and a lot of movement on that. Okay, so this is the one I'm making next. This is for my friend Bailey. This one is called Our Lady of Crochet. She's holding a ball of crochet with a bamboo crochet hook that's coming out of like a freeform crochet. This piece is by Heather Lightbody, Girl with a Hook. And it's like there's wings, and she's like behind the curtain. I love her. I think she's beautiful. I'm excited to see who this belongs to. Isn't that fun? This one also may need to be worn with leather pants. Just saying. This one has handspun yarn sleeves. And I repurposed this wool acrylic vest. And then I hand sewed this handmade belt to it. And it's got this cool panel on the back that's freeform crochet. Isn't that fun? I love that one. This one I made recently. It's inspired by Michaela Peterson, and it has a lobster on the back. I love this one. This one's for the boss, yarn boss, fearless, rock star. And then I have this one, which is almost like a coat, and this is all hand spun yarn. Well, except for up here, that's recycled sari silk. But yeah, that was fun to spin. A lot of caracal, a lot of Icelandic. Love the caracal. Love that texture. So fun. Isn't that fun? So that is a brief introduction into what I have been making with art yarn. I hope you found my garment collection inspiring, and if you're interested in purchasing any of these, I'll put my email address down below in the description of the video so that you can dibs any of them if you've fallen in love with them before they've hit my website. I'm really excited to meet the people who they belong to. Thank you so much for watching, and I'm looking forward to sharing more of my fiber art, creativity, and inspiration with you on YouTube this year. Happy spinning!